Andy is a folk singer and performer. And if many of you remember back in the day, we had before the pandemic, we were supposed to go to the Walnut Room for their all villages and dinner together. Well, that didn't happen. And Andy was going to be our guest for the evening. So we were honored to have him with us. And he's going to be bringing us some music, some sing-alongs, and ask you some pertinent questions. Andy.
Thanks, Terry. And hello, everybody. Happy Thanksgiving. And thanks so much for having me. I told Terry and Susan and others, I'm a Hyde Park alum. I spent the first 22 years of my life in Hyde Park, grew up there. Went to Bret Hart, went to lab school, and got a degree in social work, master's degree, before moving to Oak Park, where I live now. I'm going to do a couple of songs for you first. That doesn't mean you can't sing along, but we'll have lyrics up for other songs when we do more of the sing-along. The only thing I'd ask is if you're singing, please mute yourselves, only because there's a lag in the sound. And if you and I try to sing along together, it will be cacophonous as opposed to musical. But please do any singing you can do on any of these songs. This is a John Prine song. He's a local, passed away this year. One of, as Terry was talking about losing people, John Prine.
Oh, wait, Andy, you're going to have to unmute. When I mute all, I muted you. So I'm going to have to figure out how not to do that. So Andy, if you could unmute yourself. Let's see. Andy, can you hear me?
Oh, boy. I think I did it.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah.
So anyway, this first song is a song about memories, and it's called Souvenirs, which of course is the French word for memory and memories. It's a beautiful song. We miss John Prine, we miss a lot of people, but it is a blessing to think about memories that we have. All of the snow has turned to water. Christmas days have come and gone. Broken toys and faded colors are all that's left to linger on. And I hate graveyards and old pawn shops, for they always bring me tears. I can't forgive the way they rob me of my childhood souvenirs. Memories that can't be bought, can't be won at carnivals for free. Well, it took me years to get those souvenirs, and I don't know how they slipped away from me. Broken hearts and dirty windows make life difficult to see. And that's why last night and this morning they always look the same to me. And I hate reading old love letters, for they always bring me tears. Can't forgive the way they rob me of my sweetheart's souvenirs. Memories that can't be bought, that can't be won at carnivals for free. Well, it took me years to get those souvenirs, and I don't know how they slipped away from me. Thank you. I hear all that silent applause. That's so nice. We're going to have some fun a little later on, because I know somebody put up, one of you put up an Old Town School of Folk Music coffee table book. Someone else was already, before we got started, there's the book, talking about guitar lessons there. So I know this is a knowledgeable 1960s music group. So a little later on, I might test you with some of the guitar parts and see if it stirs any memories about what those songs are. Anyway, see when I start this one, if you know what it is, and if you do, sing along. It's a Beatles song. And I thought of it for today because I heard a little news clip the nightly news show with a doctor from a medical center that said every time a COVID patient got well and left the hospital, they played this song. So it's a song with a ray of hope, and see if you know it. Here comes the sun, doo-doo-doo-doo. Here comes the sun, I said, it's all right. Little darling, it's been a long, cold, lonely winter. Little darling, it seems like years since it's been clear. Here comes the sun, doo-doo-doo-doo. Here comes the sun, I said, it's all right. Little darling, I see that ice is slowly melting. Little darling, it seems like years since it's been here. Try singing with me. Here comes the sun, doo-doo-doo-doo. Here comes the sun, I said, it's all right. Sun, 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 here we come. Sun, 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 here we come. Sun, 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 here we come. Little darling, the smiles returning to the faces. Little darling, it seems like years since it's been here. Here comes the sun, doo-doo-doo-doo. Here comes the sun, I said, it's all right. Said, it's all right. So let's turn off mute for a minute. And let me just ask, did some of you recognize that guitar opening before the song started? Anybody? Or does everyone have to be unmuted, Barbara, by you?
There, I think everyone's unmuted now.
Okay.
Some people haven't.
No.
But you don't
that
need
was
to.
Fun, though.
Yeah, very
brought back memories.
Yeah. So I'm going to try a couple other Beatles songs for you now before we move into sing-along, which won't be all Beatles. But somehow the Beatles had such great, I think they often called them hooks, but such great guitar intros that everybody would always remember. So I'll just try and see if you get them. It's not necessarily the beginning of the song, it's just the guitar introduction. So try this one.
Day Tripper.
Yes, Day Tripper. Who was that? Was that nice going? Okay. All right, here's another one. I think I'm gonna be sad. Does that help?
Yeah.
Ticket to Ride,
right.
Oh.
They had that one in the movie Help. All right, this one might be a little more obscure, but I see I have some experts here, so I'm gonna try you out on it.
Norwegian Wood.
Oh my gosh, you all know it.
What was it?
Norwegian Wood.
I heard it like three times. That is so good. All right, you want one more?
Sure.
Here.
Right. Play it on us.
All right, try this. I'm not even doing it right.
Help.
Anyone?
Help.
Nope.
No. But
here's Help. Help. I need some help.
Oh,
anyway, that one was called I Feel Fine.
Yeah.
I might not have played that one so well, but I'm going to give you one more. Now, if you know Help, the Beatles had two popular movies. So see, that's a little hint, and see if you know what this one is. And then we'll move Barbara to the sing-along.
Sure.
Oh.
It's been a hard
day.
That opening chord is just amazing. It's just one chord. It's like. And they actually.
When we were all young and full of energy.
Yes, exactly right. So, okay. So let's sing a little bit together. And again, we have to mute, and I'll unmute myself after you mute yourselves. Oh, where is my light? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm just getting ready. So I've now muted everybody, and Andy, you'll need to unmute.
Okay, yeah. I am unmuted.
Okay. And everybody should be seeing, everybody should be seeing my slides, Andy's slides on my screen.
Mm-hmm. So Susan suggested this first song, Will the Circle Be Unbroken? I think, hope a lot of you know that song. And I heard you, Terry, talking about losing people this year and having special recognition. That's really what this song is about, remembering the people who came before us and not despairing, but not forgetting either. So we can certainly, all the lyrics are here, and let's just sing it together. I can see your lips moving, so I'll know when it's going or not. Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better those our earthly story, will we join them in their bliss? So to the chorus, will the circle be unbroken by and by? In the joyous days of childhood, oft they talk of wondrous love, pointed to the wondrous Savior. Now they dwell with Him above. Let's do another verse. We remember songs of heaven, which we sang with childish voice. Do you love the hymns they taught you, or our songs of earth your choice? Now the chorus, will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? Banner home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. One more verse and chorus. We can picture happy gatherings round the fireside long ago, and we think of tearful parting when they left us here below. One more chorus. Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home awaiting in the sky. Thank you for singing along on that. Let's go, Barbara, to the next song. And if I see some nods, you all know this song? If I had a hammer? Yes. Okay. So no introduction needed. You know, in these times, some of these folk songs and other songs, the meaning doesn't go away. A little different context, but still, we're still looking for justice and freedom and love, right? If I had a hammer, I'd hammer in the morning, I'd hammer in the evening, all over this land. I'd hammer out danger, I'd hammer out warning, I'd hammer out love between my brothers and my sisters all over this land. Ooh, I had a bell, I'd ring it in the morning, I'd ring it in the evening, all over this land. Bring out danger, I bring out warning, I bring out love between my brothers and my sisters all over this land. Ooh, I had a song, I'd sing it in the morning, I'd sing it in the evening, all over this land. Danger, I'd sing out warning, the love between my brothers and my sisters all over this land. Ooh, well, I got a hammer and I got a bell. I got a song to sing all over this land. It's the hammer of justice. My brothers and my sisters all over this land. It's the hammer of justice. It's the bell of freedom. It's a song about love between my brothers and my sisters all over this land. All right, for 10 extra bonus points, who made that song popular? And there can be more than one answer.
Uh-oh. Peter, Paul, and Mary.
Peter, Paul, and Mary.
Peter, yeah. Paul, and Mary. And you know who else?
Pete Seeger. Didn't Pete,
Pete Seeger? Yeah.
I think, did Pete Seeger write that song?
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah.
I was going to look it up before today, and I forgot to do that. But I think he did. And I think Trini Lopez had a hit with that song too, but I'm not certain.
Oh.
And I'm going to give you, before we click to the next slide, we're going to switch, move to some different, all of these songs, or most of them, are from the 1960s, or at least were popular then, that we're going to do today, but they're not all folk songs. So before we go to the next one, just tell me if you know what this is, if you hear this. Anyone?
Sunshine on a Rainy Day.
Yes. And the title of that song is?
My Gal.
My
Gal.
Girl.
Girl.
Perfect.
I just looked up if I had a hammer. Yes. It was written by Pete Seeger and Lee Hayes.
Oh, okay. And Lee Hayes and Pete Seeger both, maybe at the time it was written or maybe after, were part of that group called the Weavers.
Yeah.
And that's where Pete Seeger got his start.
I just put in the chat a link to the Trini Lopez version.
Oh, I was right. That's true.
Oh. I didn't know of it, so.
Oh, great. I'm not sure I can look at chat and do the single at the same time. Anyway, we're going to do the song My Girl. So, Barbara, let's have those words up. Sunshine on a cloudy day. When it's cold outside, I got the month of May. Get back to my girl. Back, 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 back. Oh, there we go. Well, I'd guess you'd say, what can make me feel this way, my girl? Talking about my girl, my girl. I got so much honey, the bees envy me. I got a sweeter song, baby, than the birds up in the trees. Well, I guess you'd say, what can make me feel this way? My girl, my girl, my girl, talking about my girl, my girl. I don't need no money, fortune or fame. riches, baby, that one man can claim. Well, and you know, when we get to the My Girl part, some of you are just going to have to pick one of those echoes of My Girl and sing it out loud. You get three chances, three to pick one. You did great. And what was the label that all those songs were on? Remember? My Girl. And this next
one. Is that Motown?
The Motown label, right. I'll play you another one that we aren't going to do. We'll go to the next one. A lot of the Motown song, many Motown songs were written by Carole King. And it wasn't, she wrote, I'm forgetting now who the lyricist was, but she was did the music. And they were a team and they worked in kind of a hit factory, and they were, all her songs were hits. We're gonna do two of them today. But at the time, she was kind of unknown, just the writer of the songs. And it wasn't until the 1970s that Carole King came out with her own album and people learned, you know, how good she was. While we're doing this and have Up on the Roof on, I mean, who were your favorite groups? I love the Beatles and I loved a lot of these Motown tunes and Peter, Paul, and Mary. What favorite groups do all of you have?
Well, I was a major Peter, Paul, and Mary fan. I had their albums together, and then I had the Peter, Paul, and Mary separate albums. So I've always loved them and seen them in person about half a dozen times.
Yeah, great.
Joan Baez. And also less well known, but Buffy St. Marie.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes.
Love her. Buffy St. Marie.
Oh,
yes. Yeah. I don't know what I had a Buffy St. Marie album, and I remember that cover of a first one, probably not an only one.
Pete Seeger was a favorite of mine when I was a student at Oberlin College. He came and gave a concert every year.
Wow.
He was a great performer.
Anybody remember the Stone Ponies? I was a fan of theirs.
Yes, yeah. I remember.
Were they the group that Linda Ronstadt was with until Linda she Ronstadt. Went off on her
yes.
own?
Yeah, that was them. Yeah.
All right, great. Well, this is really fun. And if, you know, with me or with anyone else, you could always focus a sing-along on any one of these groups, because they had such a wonderful set of music. You could play Peter, Paul, and Mary all day, and you could play Pete Seeger all day, and so on. Anyway, let's try this Up on the Roof.
And this old world starts getting me down, and people are just too much for me to face. I climb way up to the top of the stairs, and all my cares just drift right into space. On the roof's as peaceful as can be, let me
me tell you now, when I come home feeling tired and beat, I go up where the air is fresh and sweet. And if you were back doing the backup, you'd be singing up on the roof. I get away from the hustle and crowd and all that rat race noise down in the street. On the roof's the only place I know where you just have to wish to make it so. Let's go up on the roof. And at night the stars put on a show for free. The top there. At night the stars put on a show for free. And darling, you can share it all with me. I keep on telling you that right smack dab in the middle of town, I found a paradise that's trouble proof. Sing up on the roof. And if this world starts getting you down, there's room in a fortune up on the roof. Go up on the roof. Great. Now, Barb, we can go to the next slide. This, I'm pretty sure, looking at people on this Zoom call predates all of us. This was a 1920s song. And one time when I was surfing around in old movies on Turner Classic or something, I saw a film of soldiers on leave, or, you know, one of the scenes was soldiers on leave during World War I. And there was a guitar player. There were couples in the park who was romantic with moonlight. And then this guy came out and sang this song. And I didn't know if the song might've been about he and his guitar, or if it was about the friends that were in the park, the couples. Anyway, does everyone know this song? I think so.
Yes.
I hope so. Oh, we ain't got a barrel of money. Maybe we're ragged and funny, but we'll travel along, singing a song side by side. Oh, we don't know what's coming tomorrow. Maybe it's trouble and sorrow, but we'll travel the road, sharing our load. Side by side, through all kinds of weather, what if the sky should fall? Just as long as we're together, it doesn't matter at all. Well, they've all had their quarrels and parted. We'll be the same as we started, just a traveling alone, singing a song, side by side to the bridge, through all kinds of weather. What if the sky should fall? Just as long as we're together, it doesn't matter at all. When they've all had their quarrels and parted, we'll be the same as we started, just a traveling alone, singing a song, side by side. I really mean it. Side by side, a shoo-be-doo-ah, side by side. You feel at the end of that song, there should be a little like dance movement with hands. Shoo-be-doo-ah. Okay, I think we can keep going. This is another Carole King song. Do you know this one too? Yes? I can't see everybody. Let me see if I can just scroll for a minute. All nods. We all get this little bar. Yes, you've got a friend. So for extra thought, besides Carole King writing it, who else made this song popular? Unmute yourself to answer.
James Taylor.
James Taylor is right. The points are racking up out there. There are many winners. Anyway, when Carole King played this song, James Taylor played the guitar part on the recording. But I don't think Carole King played on James Taylor's recording. Same song, though. Beautiful song. Good for this time of year. Good for when, any time when you want someone to reach out via Zoom or some way and just, you know, be there for you. The chorus. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, knocking upon your door. go to the next life. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Oh, baby, don't you know about winter, spring, summer, or fall? All you gotta do is call, and I'll be there, yes, I will. Now, ain't it good to know that you've got a friend when people can be so cold? Your soul if you let them. Ah, oh, but don't you let them. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Gotta do is call, and I'll be there, yeah, yeah, yeah. You've got a friend. You've got a friend. Ain't it good to know you've got a friend? Ain't it good to know you've got a friend? Oh, yeah. Got a friend. Beautiful song, isn't it? So the next song, might as well go to that, I think, because it fits with a couple of you who said you loved Peter, Paul, and Mary. And Peter, Paul, and Mary did a lot of songs written by one person. Who was that? Besides, who was the person that they made his songs famous, but when a lot of people didn't know his versions? Who wrote this song?
Bob Dylan.
Bob Dylan is right. And like, tell me if you know what this song is. This is a Bob Dylan song that was made famous by a folk rock group called The Byrds.
Hey, Mr. Tam. I'm sorry, I don't mean to keep answering, Mr. Tambourine.
I'm glad you're answering. So anyway, Bob Dylan, controversial personality, but the most incredible poet of, I think, a few generations. And there have been a few documentaries. There's a newer one out that I want to see that I hear is very good. But this song asks 9 questions, and there's a chorus in between each time that says the answer is blowing in the wind. I don't believe he ever really answered what he was thinking by that. So it's like a lot of poetry, and I know there's a lot of interest in poetry in this group from hearing what's coming up, Terry and all. But you don't want to tell people too much so that poems can be interpreted by the listener. Anyway, I hope you will sing along with me. How many roads must a man walk down before you can call him a man? How many seas must the white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? How many times can the cannonballs fly before they are forever banned? The answer
answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. How many years can a mountain exist before it is washed to the sea? How many years can some people exist before they're allowed to be free? How many times can a man turn his head and pretend that he just doesn't see? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. How many times must a man look up before he can see the sky? How many ears must one man have before he can hear people cry? How many deaths will he take till he knows that too many people have died? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. One more. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
Boy, reading some of these lines while I'm singing them, don't they sound like they could have been written today?
I think we still have these same questions.
Yeah. And the same answer.
Yeah.
But other thoughts? How is our time?
The lyrics do seem timely, very timely.
Yes. Well, it's 1 o'clock. Do we have time for a couple more?
I think so.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay.
The last two are
You're looking for thankful songs. And Barbara, let's go to this next one.
Hey, it's one of my favorites.
I don't know about you, but I think I learned this at Bret Hart's school. Maybe from one of my teachers. Anyone else go to Bret Hart who's living in Hyde Park now? I don't know how many of you grew up in Hyde Park or moved there as adults.
I didn't grow up in Hyde Park, but the children's choir always sang this.
Yeah. It's possible I was in the children's choir. Very possible. Anyway, let's try this. This is not a song that I have sung much since then, but it's always in my head. I love this song. So we'll see how it goes singing together. And when Nancy, my wife Nancy, was at this sing-along today on Zoom, was looking at this, she was looking at the lyrics and saying, you know, I think this is like a dance too. You look at that when we find ourselves in the place just right, the next line, to bow and to bend, we will not be ashamed, to turn and to turn will be our delight, till by turning, turning, we come round right.
And it's a shaker song.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And they were also known for their dancing.
So
I bet that line is...
Yep, that line is specific for them. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Well, let's sing it together. And, you know, you're all in your own home. So if you want to get up and do a little shaker dance or shake your, you know, whatever, feel free. 'Tis a gift to be simple. 'Tis a gift to be free. 'Tis a gift to come down where we ought to be.
When we find ourselves in the place just right, we'll be in the valley of love and delight. When true simplicity is gained, to bow and to bend, we will not be ashamed. To turn and to turn will be our delight, till by turning, turning, we come round right. I don't see any dancing going on. 'Tis a gift to be simple, 'tis a gift to be free, 'tis a gift to come down where we ought to be. When we find ourselves in a place just right, we'll be in the valley of love and delight.
Thank you so much. Well, it's been really a delight to be with you. We're going to do one more song, and we can go to that. Who knows who wrote this song? Speaking of grandfathers or fathers of folk music,
isn't this another Pete?
It was sung by Pete Seeger, but not written by Pete Seeger.
Okay.
Woody Guthrie?
Yes, Woody Guthrie. And Woody Guthrie wrote this song. Pete Seeger, I think, probably made it famous, and so did Peter, Paul, and Mary. And probably wherever you may have gone to camp or whatever, you made it famous. It's a really great sing-along song. But when Woody Guthrie wrote this, he was tired of hearing one of the songs about America. Not My Country, 'Tis of Thee. Nancy, do you remember which one it was?
America the Beautiful?
America the Beautiful, right. It was on all the time on the radio in the 1940s, and he wanted to write an alternative song that would be as patriotic and laudatory of this wonderful country that we live in, and he wrote this song. So here, about this land is your land, and so here we go. So let's do this song, and we'll be done for today, and hopefully a lot of these songs will keep floating around in your head as in the days to come, and you can be singing, humming to yourselves. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. As I went walking that ribbon of highway, I saw above me that endless skyway. I saw below me that golden valley. This land was made for you and me. You can clap and sing. Here we go. This land is your land, my land, from California to the New York Island, Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. I roamed and rambled and followed my footsteps to the sparkling sands of her diamond. All around me, a voice was sounding. This land was made for you and me. This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. Here's a little lesser known verse. When the sun came shining, then I was strolling in the wheat fields waving, and the dust clouds rolling, and the voice was chanting as the voice.
voice was lit, heart was lifting. This land was made you and me. One more. This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island, the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream water. This land was made for you and me. This land was made. This land was made for you and me. Thank you very much.
Well, a round of applause for Andy. You certainly brought some joy and light into our day as we get ready to celebrate Thanksgiving. Staying home, and also a foggy day here in Hyde Park anyway.
Right.
Thank you so much. I do want to clarify one thing, and that is Sarah Peritsky. It's on a Wednesday the 16th, and because it's not a regular Hyde Park Village Wednesday drop-in, and we're inviting all the villages across Chicagoland and the Center for Life and Learning at Fourth Presbyterian Church to join us, we have to have a special sign-in Zoom call. So everybody has to register. You do not have to be a member of any village. You can bring a friend, family, neighbor, even your enemy, and invite someone, but join us. And the email will be on the website. And then if you're spending the day eating alone or with a small group of people in your own little pod, and you want to make some connections and have conversations, join the Zoom call at 2:30.
And let me just add a note, Terry, about the Sarah Peritsky. If you want to order books from the seminary co-op, she will go in and sign them before they're sent out to you. Just make a note. When you place your order, just make a note that you'd like a signed copy. And she periodically walks over and does that. And the last day for signed copies would be 7 p.m. of the day of our program, December 16th.
Oh, and Terry, the 2:30 call you were talking about is tomorrow. That's the thing.
It's tomorrow, Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
You can connect and have conversations and talk about your food or what you wish you would have had. Or
the registration for Sarah Peritsky is actually through Zoom, and it's a very simple registration process. So all we need is your name, address, and email address, and then you get the Zoom link for the Sarah Peritsky program. We're just doing it as a way to get that Zoom link out to more people without posting it on the internet.
No fees.
No
charge. It is very easy.
Do members all have to register too?
Yes, members.
Everybody has to register.
Okay.
Yeah.
To get the information.
Yeah. Okay. But it's a very simple process.
Yeah. Very easy. And then you'll get an automatic immediate email that has the Zoom link.
And it'll say Chicago Hyde Park Village at the top. So,
but is the registration only on the website? Or are you
Once you get the email, Mary, there will be a link in the email that you click on.
Oh, I see.
And that will take you to the Zoom site to register. And like I said, it's real quick, real simple. Easier than registering on the website.
Sylvia Dawson just held up a copy of Sarah's book.
Oh, good. I haven't read it yet. So.
Oh, Sylvia, hold it up again.
Yes, Sylvia, a little promo here. There.
Oh. Oh, yes. Okay.
Thank you, Sylvia.
Don't forget your cookie recipes.
Yes.
Yes, cookie recipes.
The booklet's going to be a collector's item.
Yes.
Honestly, the submissions are really interesting. So.
And it might go on next year's the gala celebration as an item you bid on.
So even if you don't bake, but you have a favorite cookie, you can send in that recipe.
Yeah, there you go.
And even if you don't submit a cookie, you can still join the event.
Yes.
And
you'll get a cookie booklet.
Is that a new book of Sarah's?
Yes, it's brand new.
It's just called Sarah Peritsky?
No, it's called Deadland.
Bedlam.
Oh. Dead, dead, okay. D-E-A-D, dead. Can you hold it up a little bit higher? There you go.
I didn't
dead
know.
Land.
See that? Oh, so, Anthony, we want to thank you for being with us. If you need to go, feel free to leave us. We really enjoyed having you.
Yes.
Thank you all for joining us. Best wishes for your Thanksgiving. Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me. I really enjoyed being with you.
Thank you, Andy.
So much. It's been a great session.
Thank you. That book cover speaks to the power of Sarah Paretsky's name, because the publisher made her name in such large font.
Yeah.
All right, bye all, Terry.
Bye. Happy Thanksgiving, bye, everybody.
Happy Thanksgiving. Be safe.
Thank you for having this. It's been fun.
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye. Thank you.